Today we're going to learn about the for loop. The for loop is really kind of simple. All you have to do is type for open and close paren, give it a variable, say equals, then do open and close square bracket, your begin value, which is 0 in this case. Then we're going to do 60, and then we're going to do to 360. So I'm basically using this as a angle in a circle. So the next thing we want to do is create an open and close paren, or excuse me, open and close curly bracket. Then we want to say rotate, open and close paren, open and close square bracket, 0, comma, 0, comma, and the last one will be I, which is our variable in the for loop. Then to see what's going on, we're going to say echo, open and close paren, we're going to put an I in there, and then we also have to add our open and close curly bracket, because we've got more than one thing that we're doing. And indent this so it's a little bit more visible. And then we're going to say square, open and close paren, open and close square bracket. Then we're going to say it's 10 by 10. And then end that with a semicolon. So what are we going to see? So what we see is a star shape. And then if we look at the echoes down here in the console, we see it starts at 0, then increments by 60. So let's change this to 45 so we can get a better idea of what's occurring, and re-render. And now we have basically two squares rotated around each other. So all you have to understand is that this is your variable, I, and this is the rotation that we're giving it right here. So this variable starts off at 0, then increments by 45. So it'll be 0, 45, and then count up, as you can see in the console window. And that gives a rotation of squares. So if you like my video, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.